Good afternoon students, welcome back to the class. Dear students, in this class we shall start to learn the another new chapter that is called data structure. So this is the fourth chapter according to your syllabus. In this particular chapter they are asking a 14 marks question in your examination, that is one question in 1 mark session and one question in 3 mark session and also two question in 5 marks session. So totally they are asking a 14 marks question in your examination. So this chapter, which is important and also weightage chapter in the sake of your examination. Okay, now let me start to discuss about this chapter, that is data structure. So here in the data structure, first we want to know about what is data. So here the data is a raw fact or a collection of raw fact that can be calculated and manipulated by our computer system. So here the data is a collection of raw fact, which can be calculated or manipulated by our computer system. So here to processing this data, the data should be organized in a particular form, which is leads the structuring of data. So here to processing data, this data should be organized in a particular form. Andre data na here data na process maadbeku andre ella data en maadbeku ondu particular form alli organized aagirbeku, which is leads the structuring of data, is called as data structure. So then what is data structures means, the data structure which is a organization or a collection of data in a appropriate form, which is improves the efficiency of processing or storing of the data. So here the appropriate definition of this data structure is a specialized format for organizing and storing the data. So the data structure is a specialized format. For organizing and storing the data. Data na organized maadi store maaduvanta ondu specialized format ge naavu data structure anta karitivi. So here in this data structure the data is a collection of raw facts. So to processing this data, the data should be organized in a particular form. Andre data na naavu process maadbeku andre ella data nu ondu particular way alli athva particular form alli or appropriate form alli maadbeku organized aagirutte. Aa organized aadantha data na, which is leading the structuring of data, that is structure is called as data structure. So the definition of this data structure, which is a specialized format for organizing and storing the data. Data na store maadi organize maaduvanta specialized format ge naavu data structure anta karitivi. So this data structure, which can be divided into two types, one is primitive data structure, another one is non primitive data structure. So this primitive data structure, which is including integer, floating point, characters and also pointers, and the non primitive data structure, which is again divided into two types, one is linear data structure, another one is non-linear data structure. So this linear data structure, which is again divided into three types, that is the first one is array, the second one is file, the third one is list. So here this array are of the three types. One is one dimensional array, two dimensional array, and also three dimensional array. And here the list can be again further divided into three types. That is, the first one is stack, the second one is queue, and the third one is linked list. So this is the types of linear data structure. And the second type of the non-primitive data structure is non-linear data structure. This non-linear data structure, which is again divided into two types, one is trees, another one is graph. So in this class, let me start to learn about the first type of the data structure, that is called primitive data structure. The first type of the data structure, which is called as primitive data structure. Primitive data structure. So here DS stands for data structure. Then what is a primitive data structure? The data structure that can be directly operated by the machine level instruction, that data structure is called as primitive data structure. Primitive data structure means the data structures directly operated by the machine level instruction are called primitive data structure. Here PDS stands for primitive data structure. This is the short form for the primitive data structure. The data structure which can directly operated by the machine level instruction, that data structure we call it as primitive data structure. This primitive data structure, which is includes integers, floats, character sign, pointer, etc. So here this primitive data structure, which the data structure is directly operated by the machine level instruction. Yaavu vandu data structure direct aagi machine level instruction inda operate aagutho aa vandu data structure ke naavu primitive data structure anta karuthe. So this primitive data structure, which is including the integers, floating points, characters, and also pointers, etc. So here there are various operations are performed on this primitive data structure. So the next concept is operations which are performed on the primitive data structure. The operations on primitive data structure. Here the PDS is primitive data structure. There are four main operations are performed on this primitive data structure. That is, the first one is create, second one is destroy, the third one is select, fourth one is update. These four are the major four operations which are performed on the primitive data structure. So here the first one is create operations. Here this create operation, which is used to create the new data structure, and this create operation, which is reserves the memory space for the program element. Program element ge bekadantha aa memory space na ee create operation maarute reserve maadi ittukolutte. So it reserves memory space for program element. Memory space for program element. This create operations which is used to create the new data structure, and the function of this create operation is which is reserves the memory space for the program element. Program element ke bekaagiruvanta memory space na idhe maadi reserve maadi ittkolu. So the second operation is destroy operation. So this destroy operation which is used to remove the data structures from the memory, which is used to remove the data structures from the memory space. Memory alliyiruvanta data structure na remove maaduvanta function na ee destroy operations will perform. So these destroy operations which is used to removes the data structures from the memory space. So here in this destroy operation, after the program execution ends, the data structures will automatically destroy and also the memory allocated eventually deallocated. ee destroy operation alli enagutte andre nam en program na execute martivo aa program execution mugid takshana डेटा स्ट्रक्चर ऑटोमेटिकली डिस्ट्रॉय अथवा डिलीट आगे आमले अली मेमोरी स्पेस डीअलोकेट आगे. सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस डिस्ट्रॉय ऑपरेशन. दिस इज द सेकंड ऑपरेशंस व्हिच आर परफॉर्मड ऑन द प्रिमिटिव डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. द थर्ड ऑपरेशंस ऑन द प्रिमिटिव डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इज सेलेक्ट. दिस सेलेक्ट ऑपरेशन which can be used by the programmer to accessing the data, to accessing the data within the data structure. Data structure alli iruvanta data na access madodakke within the data structure. ಈ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ which can be used by the programmer. Programmer ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ to accessing the data within a data structure. Data structure ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ data ನ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ programmer ಈ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಈ data ನ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. So this is the third operation. The fourth operation is update operation. This update operation I will write here. The fourth one is update operation. This can be used to change the data of the data structure. The fourth one is update operation. Update operation which can be used to change the data, of data structure. Data structure alli iruvanta data na change maadlike ee update operation na use maadtivi. So the best example of this update operation is assignment operator. Example is assignment operation. Assignment operation is the best example for this update. Let me consider one example. Int x is equal to 2 and again assign the x value is equal to 4. Here the 2 is assigned to x and here the 4 is assigned to x. Here the value 2 is assigned to a and here the value 4 is assigned to x. Now the present value of the x is 4. So here in this given example the value 2 is assigned to x and again the value 4 which is assigned to x, but finally we got present the result, the value of x is 4, because here the 2 is automatically replaced by the 2 replaced by 4, that is from update operations. ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇದು ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ದಿ ಡೇಟಾ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಡೇಟಾ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದನ್ನ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೋ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಈ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು x ಗೆ 2 ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಅಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೀಗೆ ರೀಅಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ 4 x ಗೆ 4 ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ರೀಅಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ x ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ 4 ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ 2 ಇಸ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ರಿಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ದಿ 4 4 ಇಂದ 2 ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ರಿಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ x ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ 4 ದಿಸ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಮೆಷಿನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮೈನ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ The second one is destroy, which is used to remove the data structures from the memory. And the third one is select operation. That select operations which can be used by the programmer to accessing the data. Data na access maadlikke programmer inda use aagutte. And the fourth operation is update operation, which is used to change the data of the data structures. And here this is the best example for this update operation. So these four are the operations which are performed on this primitive data structure. This primitive data structure, which is the first type of the data structure. So now we'll move on to the second type of the data structure, that is non-primitive data structure. This non-primitive data structure, which is the complex level of the data structure. ಈ ನಾನ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡಿರೈವ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಈ ನಾನ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಈ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಂದನೇ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಆಗಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಟಿವ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ linear data structure so here this linear data structure which is the type of data structure which is has a homogeneous element that element can be referred by the index so linear data structure is a type of data structure it has a homogeneous element it has a homogeneous element that can be referred by the index in linear data structure anthadu data structure du ondu type here it has a homogeneous element that element can be referred by the index homogeneous element means same type of the element ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೇ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ನೇ ನಾವು ಹೋಮೋಜೀನಿಯಸ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಮೋಜೀನಿಯಸ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರೆಫರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ರೆಫರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೆಮ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ all the data will have a linear relationship between them andre ella data element na naduve linear relationship ee linear data structure alli irutte so here also as like a primitive data structure there are various operations are performed on this linear data structure that is the first one is traversal traversal. The second one is insertion. Insertion. The third one is deletion. The fourth one is selection. Fifth one is sorting. And sixth one is merging. So these six operations which are performed on this linear data structure. So here this traversal, insertion, deletion, selection, sorting, merging, these six are the operations which are performed on this linear data structure. Okay, I will stop here. From these linear data structure operations, we'll continue in the next class. Thank you all.